Thank you for coming by, Tori Magoo 44. Today is September 25th, 2014, and it is 90 degrees in Burbank, California, in September, the end of September. We're almost into October. Unreal. Really, really hot. But we're getting along, and I'm going to make a video today. Basically, I've been watching TV and watching various sports shows, and I'm amazed to see Scientology constantly pitching how wonderful everything is, you know, how fabulous. Oh, we're so happy. Oh, let me tell you my wins. Oh my God. Oh, I just realized I could clear the planet. And so that's it. I joined staff. That's what happened. I care about mankind. That's why I'm joining staff. That's it. That's the only reason. I love mankind, and I want to help mankind. I mean, believe it or not, that's actually how I felt when I was in the Church of Scientology, and that's how they feel to this day. Everything's just so fabulous inside. Come on in. You've got to join, too. I mean, how could you not? I mean, I know, okay, you're working a job, you're making $100,000 a year, great, but what are you doing for mankind? How are you helping? Are you doing anything? No, you're not really doing anything, but we are. We're making a difference. Okay, now that's the basic pitch of Scientology over and over and over. You'll hear it. How great it is, how fabulous we are, how much better my life is, and you need to come in and do it too. And we're helping mankind. Okay, now let's start with number one. Are they really happy? Well, a lot of them are bankrupt because they gave their money to the Church of Scientology. But that's okay because they're giving fundraisers. We're making money. We're getting it in. Now, what's happening with that money? The scavengers buying buildings. That's it. They're not even using the tech anymore. So, and the tech is their Hubbard's stuff that he said he could use to clear the planet, right, to help mankind. They're not even using that anymore. They're just buying buildings. That's really the game, that and some of their front groups. Look at Narcanon. I'll put a couple of links in here with Tony Ortega talking about what's happened recently with Narcanon. It's coming out. It really is. It's finally, finally getting exposed for the abusive, phony, unreal, not drug education program that it really is. And Clark Carr, what are you thinking of running it? You used to be a comedian. You were actually funny. You were way better as a comedian than you are running Narcanon. And why run this knucklehead organization where people are dying, not getting help? There's no medical doctor on staff. You know, it's really a bad news scene. So if you're thinking of putting your kid in Narcanon, look and learn all that has gone down with Narcanon before you give them a dime or your name or your number. And that's true for any of Scientology front groups. Narcanon, Criminon, Way to Happiness, Applied Scholastics, and let's not forget WISE, their business management organization, which, yeah, it sounds okay. I'm sure they can give you a few little tips, but you know what? Truth is, you can buy those same tips for $29.95, $19.95, or free on the internet. So why pay Scientology thousands of dollars when the truth is, really their only goal is to get you into underneath that umbrella called the Church of Scientology International. And you go and tell me it isn't, Scientologists. Just try. Come on over. Come talk to me. They can't. Now, there is one. They can't talk to people anymore. They sell communication. They sell freedom. But they can't talk to anybody unless you agree with them. If you agree with them, come on in. Oh, we're having such a great time. But wait a minute. You have a critical thought? Oh, wait a minute. No. No, we got to go. We gotta go. Come on, let's go. Really? That's freedom? That's communication? I mean, think of every... This is what my parents used to say it all the time. And my father was a celebrity, but he was a very humble man and a very cool guy. And my mom used to say all the time, if you have to pitch how great you are, you just lost the greatness. That's it. Because great people don't do that. They don't go around saying how great they are. They're just doing things, and the things happen to be medium, very good, excellent, fantastic, right? But they're not having to pitch them because that's how great people are. They don't have to say they're great. They just do great things. So when you hear Scientology always saying how great we are, what other church, which they are not a church, they're a business, fraudulent business, phony business that doesn't even deliver what they say they promise, and they charge exorbitant fees for all of it, don't deliver it. Part of their technology is, Hubbard said, hey, if they don't like it, give them their money back, get rid of them. Will they give us our money back? I'm owed at least $100,000, Scientology, at least. Okay, so pay up. And God knows, I mean, if it ever comes down where they have to actually do what they're supposed to do, it's over. It's over. So it's a matter of continuing to hammer the IRS, because they're in their pocket too. But if you let enough people know around that, somehow something's going to flush out. And continue social networking, which is fantastic. If you see, like, I'm going to put these links for some very key things. There was a talk show we did yesterday with Tony Ortega, Mark Bunker, and a little bit by me. But Tony does a really good thing, and so does Mark Bunker. Take that link and put it on your social networking. You know what I mean? Twitter it. Get these things out and around so that people don't get suckered in. Most of the time they're not, but some of them still are. And why? What's the point? They are not doing great things. Name a thing that you're doing that's great, Scientology. Name one thing. Name it. Oh, we're getting study tech into, you know, Babadaboo in Africa. Really? And that's your great thing? No, it isn't. Or we would be hearing about it. Narconon. Yeah, that's going to hell. Criminon. Who knows what's happening there? That's where they do Way to Happiness in prisons. Now, what's the real intention of that? That the guys will come out and get into Scientology. So if you're in prison and you hear this, don't buy it, okay? Because that's their real goal, is to get you in Scientology, period, okay? WISE, World Institute of Scientology Enterprises, gag me with the spoon. They're some of the most out ethics people I've ever known. I work for them, and you know who you are if you are part of WISE, and you know that you don't apply the tech correctly. You're there to get people's money, and that's it. That's the truth. That's a fact for Scientology in general. Get the money and pitch how great we are. Okay, so are they great? No. Do they say they're great? Over and over and over. All you have to do is ask yourself what great people that you know or that you've ever thought were great, artists, musicians, humanitarians, did any of them have to say how great they are? No. Does Scientology have to do it all the time? Yes. And other cults all the time? Yes. Why? Because they're not really great. That's the essence of it. Great? Not great? Not great. But don't believe me. I say, look at both sides. Go on the internet and study up and find out for yourself. But do not walk into their buildings until you've learned both sides, because they are very good at trapping people. That's what they do. Listen to Trapped by Bruce Springsteen. That's Scientology. And it's not as good as Bruce Springsteen, believe me. All right, you guys, I love you. And I hope you have an excellent end of the week and into the weekend. Peace out, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.